Hello YouTube, this is Bowtied Media, and today I have a review of Burial and Blackdown's Shock Power of Love EP. Burial and Blackdown are two artists that I have never really heard of before this point, but they ended up on my radar some way or another, and here we are, reviewing this EP. Burial seems to be a fairly popular name with about 500,000 monthly listeners on Spotify, with Blackdown being at about 1,000, so I'm not sure how the two got in touch with this project, but they did. And might I say, this is by far one of the most unique formats I have ever seen for an EP. So what do I mean by that? Well, it's a four-track EP with two artists, Blackdown and Burial. So you would assume all four tracks are made by both artists. It's a collaboration, four songs are made by two different people. That would make sense. That's where you would be wrong, as Burial has two individual 10-minute tracks, well, Blackdown has two remixes on this project. So the track list literally goes Blackdown remix, Burial song, Blackdown remix, Burial song. And it's just something I have never seen before. But with those two 10-minute tracks, it means that this four-song EP clocks out at around 27 minutes. But on the production side of this project, Burial and Blackdown both do primarily UK garage, with Blackdown taking a more deep house approach to his tracks. Considering the format of the EP that I just talked about, I'm surprised how well everything flowed together and just almost transitioned seamlessly. While the two do produce in similar genres and styles, I was really surprised how well they actually meshed together. It didn't seem super jarring going from one producer to another. The styles didn't conflict in any way, and honestly, if you had told me that this was just the same artist four songs in a row and they weren't even remixes, I would have believed you. I would have no reason not to. All this is essentially me just saying that while this is a really, really strange format I haven't seen before, it works. It all flows well and it works as an EP. So let's jump into it track by track here. The Journey VIP is the first track here, and it is Blackdown's VIP of his original song. And I have very personally not listened to the original version of this song, just this VIP from this EP. It's a lot of P's there. But yeah, this is kind of what I talked about earlier, where it's a UK garage style track with some hits and hints of deep house. It's got one of those kind of cliche underground track styles in terms of a kind of woman vocalist just yelling at you, challenging you to be your best kind of person. It reminds me a lot of Disclosure. But honestly, without those vocals and vocal performance, if you could say, the track would be pretty boring. And well, ironically, this track is less than half of the length of both of Burial's songs. I think it's a little more repetitive, and it sounds the most repetitive than anything else on this 27-minute long EP. And speaking of Burial, the second track on this EP is his first with Dark Gethsemane. This track, without a doubt, pulls off the greatest atmosphere of anything on this project, I would say, hands down. It's got this haunting, pitched-up vocal of saying Dark Gethsemane with this wind in the background and owls, and it makes you feel like you're in a forest late at night and someone's like following you. My interpretation of this track is it's Burial actually taking you to the Garden of Gethsemane, which is the place that, according to my belief, my Christian belief, Jesus prayed before he was betrayed by Judas and handed over to the Roman government. There's more to it than just the name here, why I think this could actually be the purpose of this track, where halfway through it starts to sound really ethereal and heavenly, and it's got these kind of chimes and almost angelic atmosphere to the track. It's like something you would hear from a movie when someone walks into a cathedral or grand church. And during the section, there is sounds of what appears to be women running to something and gasping and being in shock of something they are seeing. And to me, that my interpretation of that is the two or three women that run to the tomb after Jesus has died after 3 days and he is resurrected and he is no longer there. And the back half of the track after this says over and over again, we must shock the nation with the power of love. And again, according to my belief and my understanding of this track, I believe this to be a rallying cry to humanity based off of the resurrection of Jesus, to essentially say that Jesus made the ultimate loving sacrifice for us, and so we must shock this nation or the world with the power of love. But that is just my interpretation based off of my own faith, so I'd be really interested to hear what someone else thinks about this track who doesn't have a Christian background. But Blackdown is back for track number 3, and it is of Heat Map's Arclight, remix, of course. It's my least favorite track from the EP, and I think struggles with the same ideas of repetitiveness and dullness that his first VIP did. It does have some really fun laser and space sounds, which add to the atmosphere. Again, I think Burial does it a little bit better, but this one isn't all that bad. Where Burial comes back with a 9.5 minute track, Space Cadet, to conclude the project and continue that kind of space theme that Blackdown was working on. The track isn't as strong sonically and narratively as much as I think Dark Gethsemane was, but it does create a great atmosphere and is a lot more of an experiential track. Each of these Burial tracks have a very distinct almost chapter marks where the song feels like it could have ended and it could have been split into something else, where I could have seen this project being 8 or 9 songs long just based off those small segments, but I'm actually glad he didn't. In the end, this project has a super unique format that I have yet to see in the industry. Burial and Blackdown work super well together, particularly considering that, they don't actually collaborate on anything here. But I do believe that Burial greatly outshines Blackdown in terms of his production quality and atmospheric creation. It's a solid project with some creative UK garage and deep house sounds, where if either of those genres make you perk your ears up and you're excited for that, you're gonna love this project. And for those reasons, Burial and Blackdown's Shock Power of Love EP is going to score a 7. But thank you guys so much for watching. I have been Bowtide Media. Let me know if you've ever heard of Burial or Blackdown before this EP. I'd love to know in the comment section below, what are your thoughts on that song, especially Dark Gethsemane? What is your interpretation of it? But this has been day 2 of review month. You can see the rest of the reviews that I'm supposed to be coming out with on my Twitter, @Bowtide Media. But for now, I will see you guys in another video.